Welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Neeru Tandon from Department of English, VSSG College, Kanpur. In this paper of English language teaching, at present we are discussing teaching materials and teaching aids, technical material, and this module has been written by Dr. Shravan Kumar. Teaching is an art which includes knowledge, presentation, an art of dissemination, and above all, every aspect of paralinguistics. Teaching demands broad knowledge of subject matter in all horizons, complete curriculum with standards, positive and caring attitude with enthusiasm, and a desire for learning and techniques of classroom management, and a desire to make a difference in the life of young people. A teacher is an aid, and the activities used by the teachers are materials in the classroom. The existence of materials is totally based on the creativity and innovative ways of teachers. No one can assume even a single material without a teacher, because it is a teacher who uses the materials in the classroom effectively, and the effective usage of those materials is reflected by the involvement of these students. As per www.dictionary.com, teaching is material used by a teacher to supplement classroom instruction or to stimulate the interest of students, unquote. As per Merriam-Webster, teaching aid is an object such as a book, picture, or a map, or device such as DVD, computer, or mobile, used by a teacher to enhance or enliven classroom instructions. As per Merriam-Webster, material denotes or consists of physical objects rather than the mind or spirit. Now, teaching material and teaching aids. We have gone through what is teaching material and how it is different from teaching aid. Then let us consider what is the role of teacher as teaching aid. Teacher is the driver of the classroom, who drives the class as per his or her wish and pace. He or she makes an environment in which all the students delve themselves in the ocean of knowledge, which happens due to usage of the materials and aids used by the teacher in the classroom. They use themselves as an aid when they start using facts as a starting point and ask why question, and then look at all sides and encourage students to predict what will happen next. As a material, they try to engage the whole class with their questions, and with the help of their motivation and varied questions, they make a live classroom where every student gets involved. When class becomes interactive, then there is a major role of teacher in it. As soon as teacher enters in the classroom, he or she starts using materials which already exist in the classroom. They start talking about last classes, which gives a platform to the students for getting out something, and teacher tries to link up that interaction with his or her upcoming class, and it becomes a material for a teacher. A teacher digs out the material from the classroom and uses accordingly. Like, students were scolded by a teacher of last class, and an ELT teacher can ask few students to come up and share the experience of last class, and from there that ELT teacher tries to hone the speaking skills of the students. These materials can be used to chisel the speaking skills of the students, and students will be speaking wholeheartedly, which can be a good material to be used by any ELT specialist. Teacher can use himself or herself to project anything in a better way by his or her gestures, postures, facial expressions, and voice. For example, a teacher can teach the presentation strategies to the students by his or her voice modulation, and it is the power of speech that may turn a dull topic into an interesting one, whereas poor delivery may spoil the significant presentation as well. A speech with same pitch delivered with the stating pitch becomes monotonous. So, there should be variation in pitch. The voice should be well modulated with proper pause at the right place along with normal rate of speech, and fillers should be avoided if undue. It can be easily practiced by these materials used by teacher in the classroom. We express our emotions through words, but often the feel of emotion is expressed through our various body parts, that is also known as body language. We can communicate by nodding our head, blinking our eyes, shrugging our shoulders, or working our hands. When we study body language, we look at the symbols of meaning that the physical movements of the body are communicating. Through body movements, true inner conditions are reflected. For the expression of these inner body states, faces, eyes, gestures, and physical appearance are to be studied. For self-control, the presenter should pay attention to his body language as well. These things can be easily learned by the students when they observe their teacher in the classroom and try to imitate the teacher. They do so as well because for them, teacher is the role model. First of all, they give such a high respect to teacher that they want to imitate them because they want to be like him or her. So this is the first stage where they can try, and they try to imitate not only the words but also the body language. Little John and Windett says, I quote, "Materials have a hidden curriculum that includes attitude towards knowledge, attitudes toward teaching and learning, attitude toward the role and relationship of the teacher and student, and values and attitude related to gender, society, etc. Materials have a basic instructional viewpoint, approach, method, and content, including which provide linguistic and cultural information." As Jolly and Bolitho say, materials should also be contextualized to the experiences, realities, and first languages of the learners. An important part of this involves awareness on the part of the teacher designer of the socio-cultural appropriacy of things, such as the designer's own style of presenting material, of arranging groups, and so on. Now, this guideline that help of the mother tongue should be taken to make it more clear. How appropriate it is a debatable topic. But just for an example, there is one more thing, that when you just take the help of the mother tongue inferences, then it is good for memory of the student, because according to mnemonic techniques of learning, specifically the vocabulary and other part also, if you link it to something else that is already known by the learner, then that thing easily becomes glued to the memory of the learner. For example, in my literature class, when I teach the beauty of the Cleopatra in the play All for Love by Dryden, where he has described that Cleopatra is so beautiful, and there is a particular moment when Cleopatra is angry. She is so beautiful, white complexion, and when she gets angry, then her cheeks are red with anger. She is crying also. And this particular thing, it should remain in the memory of the learners if I use one couplet that belongs to their own language. I recite that couplet. Unke jalte hue rukhsar pe dhalke aansu. Rukhsar means cheeks. Unke jalte hue rukhsar pe dhalke aansu. Maine sholon pe machalti hui shabnam dekhi hai. Now what happened? Whosoever has interest in that particular concept of Hindi and Urdu, they will just feel fresh. The monotony of the class will be broken. I am just against the translation method where everything, every part of English language you are going to teach them in Hindi. No. But as far as mnemonic technique is concerned, one must use or may take help from the mother tongue or the other related things so as to break the monotony, so as to keep the attention of the learners alive in the classroom and in the curriculum. It is required to inform about the culture-specific learning processes of the proposed learners. Materials should be interlinked by which learner can acquaint him with the material. So in this way, material from the mother tongue is also a good material to be used. The material should be based on the experiences and realities which should be related to the topics, and it should be appropriate for the desired learner to make sure of their involvement. If that couplet is not exactly explaining the same thing that is written in that particular play, then it is of no use. So material should be related and it should be well connected with the purpose. Mr. D. Hall says, most people who learn to communicate fluently in English, which is not their L1, do so by spending a lot of time in situations where they have to use the language for some real communicative purpose. Unquote. It means that the materials should stimulate interaction, and it can be achieved by providing the activities which involve the situations and their real-time conversation. Mr. D. Hall also says that the material should encourage learners to develop their learning skills and strategies and the activities such as recording of their conversations. According to D. Metrion, I quote, an antidote to the profusion of skills-based activities and artificial language use pervasive in the field of ESL instruction cannot be avoided. It clarifies that the material should be developed to help the learners towards analytical approach with a focus of learning. Bell and Gar suggested that at the very least we listen and speak together and read and write together. I think the material should be well connected with all these four skills. The learner can integrate LSRW skills with the help of the materials. Materials, they should be alluring in terms of appearance so that teacher is ready to use them and learner has also got some interest in looking and in enjoying that particular material. It should be user friendly and it should be durable as well. If any material possesses these characteristics, then all the learners, they will readily use the material wholeheartedly, which will definitely produce the positive results in the classroom. Materials should be flexible also, by which we can use those material in many places. Like a picture can be used to teach part of a speech as well as to enhance the spoken skills. Even that picture can be used to develop writing skills by the change of instructions. Materials should be authentic also, by which the acquirement will be better and faster and the students feel successful over their achievement, because the skills that they acquire make them feel that they can handle the situations in the real life too. teachers should be very cautious while choosing the materials, because the students can be demoralized if the materials are higher than the level of the students. Earlier, it was hard to see the interactive classroom. Teaching learning materials and the teaching learning environment, that's why teaching became very monotonous and students had to mostly rely on the process of mugging up without even understanding. The classroom teaching was dominated by the lecture method of teacher, and there were some essential aids like just chalk and duster and blackboard in the classroom, that's all. Teaching learning materials were hardly used in the classroom. It is popularly known as TLMs. They are being designed to disable the monotonous learning methods. These TLMs made a shift from response strengthening to knowledge acquisition for construction of knowledge. In this context, a teacher provides an environment where any student can construct his knowledge by interacting with his physical and social environment. Now, a teacher should always think about his or her students before providing TLMs. Every material is not for every child. A teacher should identify the need of developing new teaching and training material. If every time you use the same material, then students will lose their interest in the classroom, in the curriculum as well. Teachers can classify their materials according to the need and requirement, and a lesson plan can be one of the effective material also. Teacher should show a chart as an aid to the students and can ask them to identify the nouns present in the chart. Students will respond with curiosity and enthusiasm, and they can spot few names of noun. Have a look at the picture. I think students will tell the names of nouns like road, bicycle, whatever is there in that particular picture. So by telling all these things, by finding out all these things, they are not only telling the answers, rather they are having those pictures in their mind, those diagrams in their mind, and having a connection with the name and the picture itself. Now you can just ask for the spoken skill. Can you name girl in another way? Can you name boy in another way? So that way when they will respond, so their writing skills and their spoken skills will be developed in the same way. They may answer like she or he, so they will learn pronoun. After getting these answers, teacher can say that these terms can also be termed as pronoun, and then he may explain the process of noun and the pronoun. So in this interactive kind of class, both student and teachers will be active, not passive. Now, games can also be used as interesting materials in the classroom. Games can help to improve teaching and learning processes, which improve communication and social skills in the students indirectly. I would like to mention a grammar-based question game. The teacher can ask students to write separate sentences with each word which they told after observing the chart. Then they need to be instructed to write a paragraph with the help of those sentences. After this, they can be instructed to evaluate the other child's copy. You can see in this particular diagram, there is a start and then go, drive, jump to 7, watch, fight, win. So there are various words, and they can do the follow the instructions like start again. So they will go at the start. Just like in previous times we used to had Ludo. In the same way, you can have that game with the help of the words, and those words can just inspire them to learn more, to make sentences and to develop their writing skills. During evaluation of such an exercise, they can be instructed to check how many students have written all the sentences, how many sentences are correct, how many of them have used all the sentences to write a paragraph, and how many of them have used these sentences to attain coherence? Like if all of them have made sentences but there is no connection between the sentence, that may be one case. The other case may be that by using all these words, a person, a student, he has written a paragraph, a story, or something that is related with one another. So all the students will be involved in writing and evaluation, which develops the learning process of the students. A teacher should know KWL. KWL, K means know. What do they know? W means want. What do they want to learn? And L means what did finally they learn? A teacher must know before starting any topic in which he should know about the previous knowledge of the students, and the lesson plan is always based on previous knowledge, where students give the answers on the basis of their previous knowledge, which becomes the primary answers. Teacher's knowledge of KWL is very, very important. It decides the material of the topic, because if the students are acquainted with noun, then only they will try to learn pronoun, and it will show their will to learn. So the teacher should know what they are willing to learn, and in the classroom assessment, a teacher can know what they already learned. There is a thing, think, pair, share. Now what is it? In this process, a student can think individually, then in pairs, and then they can share with the whole class. A teacher can involve the students in a better way, where they can talk and share their experience with more confidence. Now, in the process of making the pair, teachers can choose those students and just make groups where some students are very active and some are less active. If he or she will make the whole group of the active or whole group of the inactive students, then rest of the students will not come forward. This material opens up the ways of honing speaking skills, where the students will be speaking after sharing their thoughts, which help them to reproduce many thoughts. Because when we talk about second language, students say that they are unable to find out the words, thoughts while speaking in English. So this material can provide the platform of ideas and thoughts. Another thing can be the 3-minute pause. The 3-minute pause provides a chance to the students to think and interpret the concepts and ideas that have just been introduced to, and it would be easy for him or her to make connections to their prior knowledge for better understanding. Human being is a creature with impetuous thoughts, and for effective communication, the synchronization of thoughts is necessary. So the instructed 3-minute break can help out the students to think and comprehend in a better way. Then recapitulation of the topic. The teacher should take care of the topic which he is going to cover in the assigned class. He may start by making a bridge between the previous knowledge and whatever he is going to teach in the present class. This can be achieved by asking questions related to the topic, just to refresh the memory and relive and have the connection with the previous topic. So, topic can be recapitulated by organizing quizzes that can be enjoyed by the students also. And just introduced topic should be recapitulated by the student, which would hone the understanding skill of the students. Now, observation is also very important. Teacher can divide the classroom into the group, and after assigning some task, teacher can walk around the classroom and observe students as they work to check for learning. What they are learning is important, but how they are learning is more important. So the observation plays a vital role to tackle the mixed ability classroom. By this method, a teacher can pay attention towards the weak students of the class who do not pay attention to the things that need their attention and hesitate to ask question in front of the entire class because they feel shy. Face-to-face conversation is again a material. A teacher should try to have a face-to-face interaction with the students, which is a key material to know the exact problems of the students. The level of understanding of the students can be better understood by face-to-face. Now, worksheets as a traditional material of the classroom, they can also be very effective for learning in an effective way. A teacher should take appropriate care while making the worksheets. Questions should be based on skills and sub-skills. Questions which are based on skills are productive and receptive. The questions based on sub-skills can provide specific information, detailed information, and general information. Students can have fill in the blanks, reveal the specific information. Multiple choice questions, identify the topic, context, function, gist, all these things, all these questions can be taken up. One may also have yes no questions, WH questions, tag questions, choice questions, hypothetical questions, and embedded questions. Now, what is the significance of teaching material? Is teacher sufficient for the classroom, or he needs those aids and material? These material are helpful for teachers or for students or for both? These are certain questions to be answered. All Right says, material should teach students to learn that they should be resource books for ideas and activities for instruction, learning, and that they should give teachers rationales for what they do, unquote. Learners are oriented towards the instruction and learning. Any syllabus or curriculum has the goals of learning, the methods of learning, etc., and teachers help the learners to learn. Teachers may adapt, supplement, and elaborate the material to disseminate the content to the students, and they need to monitor the progress of these students and finally evaluate the student. Various abbreviations commonly used in ELT are DVD, that is digital video disc, ELT, known as English language teaching, TLM, teaching learning materials, F2F, face-to-face, ESL, English as a second language, LSRW, listening, speaking, reading, and writing. So, we can just connect all these material with the teacher, and together they can just come up with a very good result that a student is going to be benefited by that. The classroom will be interactive, it will not be boring, and learning English as a second language will not be a burden. It will be a fun for both teachers and the students. Keep learning. Thank you for visiting EPG Pathshala.